I will demonstrate Dashbook's ability to handle royalty tiers. This will be better demonstrated with a music setup. And what we're going to do is set up the tiers for the first time by going to the Setup Royalty Tier Names and creating two different tiers. Of course, I could just have them Tier 1 and Tier 2. But for this demonstration, we're going to say these are publishers and labels. So those are going to be our two tiers. And the idea is that we're going to subtract the publisher royalties. Actually, we're going to recoup them from the labels. So let's go into the royalty arrangements, and we're going to need two different royalty arrangements, one for the publishers. So we'll just edit the standard one and just say publisher mechanical. So you see this is tier of publishers, and we're going to choose a mechanical and have 100% of the mechanicals. And that's all we're going to do for the publishers. And then we want to make a new royalty arrangement and call it label percent of net. So here's net. We're going to give the labels 50% of net. But what we want to do is put them in a second tier. So if we put them in a label tier, then we can deduct the royalties paid to the publishers, either before the royalty percentage, or in this case, we're going to make it a recoupment after the calculation of royalty percentage to deduct or less the royalties from publishers. And now we have two different royalty arrangements. Again, publisher on one tier, and labels are going to get the deduction from the publishers. The way we'll use this, let's create a new product. And of course, we can put an ISRC, but we're just going to call this Song 1, add as a title for now. And we're going to want some royalties on this. So let's go to the royalties, royalty holders, and we're going to say royalty holder 1 is publisher 1. Just give them your own name. And yes, we can change the contact type here, but it's not critical at this point. And then let's make a new one and call this one label 1. And now we have two different royalty holders, and we're going to make both of them a contributor to this product. Apply changes so that we can then go in for, now we have a separate section for royalties for publishers versus royalty for labels. So the royalty for publishers, we're going to choose the publisher and the publisher mechanical. You know, this song, you know, let's just say it's a $1 song, and we're going to leave the play length the same, which would be, you know, 5 minutes or less. If we needed more than 5 minutes, we would definitely want to set the play length for the mechanical calculation. And then for the labels, we'll choose a label royalty holder and then a label percent. The royalty arrangement that we're choosing here is restricted to either the first tier or the second tier, so that's why we only have this one choice. Pretty nice. And we will apply that. If we go all the way to the right, we'll see that we don't have any royalties actually accrued for this calculation. Because we don't have any orders in the system. And here we'll see that label is paying 50%, and if we look at the publisher, we'll see it's paying 100% of its style. So it's just giving you some information. It also allows you to override it if you need to. Now, if we were to, so we have a product now, we can create an order manually. Of course, normally you will just import orders. And for this time, we'll just choose the preset customer one and that particular song. And we'll just keep it at 1 unit for a dollar. When we close the order, we will have the calculation done. We can glance at the advance royalties and see we have a publisher that's participated as well as the label. And we can see which royalty description they used as well. So the publisher is using the publisher. And further to the right, we'll see that we're calculating a 9.1 cent mechanical on the publisher, and the dollar is the net amount sold on the label. 100% of 9 cents is going to flow down to be the 9.1 cents of royalty amount, whereas the label starts off with a dollar of sold. We'll take 50% of that, then it's going to deduct that this 9.1 cents. Every publisher that came before it, it's going to deduct that, and you have the 4 cents. That's how it works.